Welcome. In this training, we'll be going into a bit of a more specific topic, the monitoring tab. Let's go into the monitoring tab to the far left of the top bar. This is where you'll be using our platform for most of the time. At the top of this work area, you'll see a horizontal row of icons. The two list icons allow you to add units to the work list. You can either click the Add All Available icon here or Add to the List icon here. If you choose Add to the List option, a small window will appear. You can either double-click a specific unit or select the units you want by pressing Ctrl on your keyboard and highlighting multiple units at a time. After selecting what you want, you can add them to your current list or let the new units replace the old ones. Now that we have our units on the work list, let's organize them by groups by selecting the Group View button here. That looks a lot better. We can now see all the units split into groups. Each row in my work list represents a group, and if I expand it by clicking the plus box here, you'll see the indented rows representing individual units. Let's switch back to the unit view for the sake of the tutorial. On the left of each row, we can now see a checkbox. This is the unit's visibility and allows you to take the unit on and off the map without affecting its position on the work list. You can see the button in line with each of the unit to change their visibility individually, or use the button at the top to change them all at once. To the right of the checkbox, you can see a small icon that depicts a vehicle, and this is the unit icon for the unit on the map. This can be customized in the icon tab inside of the unit properties window, although there is a deeper understanding of this in the unit tab tutorial. You can click on this unit icon to read more of the information that the unit is getting. On the work list, you can also see every unit's name. By clicking once on a unit's name, you can auto-focus on a specific unit. If you double-click, you can pull a mini-map that only shows this unit's position. To the right of the checkbox, there is an alphabetical sorting icon. They can either be placed ascending or descending, depending on if the direction of the arrow is up or down. On the top right side of the work list, you can see another grouping of icons that line up with the unit's specific icons below. I'll explain some of the more common ones in this tutorial. The crosshair icon is the Watch Units on Map functionality. This brings the map to focus on this unit, or if multiple units are selected, it will keep the map zoomed out enough to see all the visible icons on the map. For example, I want to watch these units A and B all the time. I check this crosshair icon for them. Then, let me try to zoom in on the map on only unit B. As you can see, the map will not allow me to do it since the purpose of Watch Unit on the Map button is to keep both units A and B visible within the edges of the map. To the right of that icon, there's an icon with a circle around an arrow here that represents the motion state of the vehicle. As you can see in the key, there are several different motion states varying by color and shape. You can also click on the top icon to sort the vehicles by their motion state. To the right of this icon, we can see a satellite representing data accuracy. Similar to the motion state, it has a different meaning for varying colorations. You can see that key here. The last icon that should be explained in the basic tutorial is the Remove from List icon, represented by a large X. On most other tabs, a red X means deletion of data. But on this tab, a red X only removes the units from the work list. The unit can easily be added back by following the Add to List instructions at the beginning of this video. Congratulations and thank you for completing our tutorial on the monitoring tab. I hope by now you feel a little more at ease when operating through our platform. To further extend your knowledge of our platform, please check out our other video tutorials. I'll see you next time.